Hello guys, my name is Samar from Dasgupta, and today in this video we are going to see about the part 10 of Flutter social media chat app tutorial 2021. This is a short video. This not will be a 1 hour long video. In this video we are going to see some UI changes in external search as we done in the previous video, and also implement the search bar in external search screen. This is the associate with the previous video. So if you not see the previous video and not experience the my previous build generation chat app, the link in the description, check it out. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So guys, as I told in the intro, so we are making some UI changes in that available connections and also implement the search bar over here. Okay, so and for the UI changes, as I said, when we click on the plus, it takes some time to load the available connections. So we have to make a loader there. That will be a better user experience. Okay, so for that, we have to do one thing. In the initial data phase activity, we have to make start the loader as well. Just before the function end, we have to close that as well. Actually, this is okay. So make a hot reload. Yeah. As you can see, this takes us some time. Okay. So if I change the color of that loading overlay, I take the color from here. Email and password not is not here. Where I can found that cool. So let's make it hot reload. Okay, you can see before the connection available there is a loading. So see again. Okay, so it seems cool. Okay, now we implement the search bar over here. Okay, just down the available connection heading. So for that, What we should do? Okay guys, that's the design to make a search, and now we are going to implement the functionality. Okay, when we write something here, depending upon the changes, the reflection will show here, but here the some problem, the text in the black and it is not good, so we have to change the color of that writing text as well. So we change it as colors.white. Okay, and if we give white, just a minute, white 70, let's see what happens. Let's see, it's good, not wrong. Yeah, it seems good but not gorgeous, so I think it's better. Cool. So when we write something, that will change on time, okay, upon the real time changes. So under the text field there is a callback method present on change, and as a parameter it returns the write text. Cool. So now we have to change some previous configuration as well. So what we can do, we can make a map of sorted available user. The sorted data will store here. Okay, so sorted available user. So in the on change method, first thing first, we have to start the loading because sorting takes some of time, so that will be helpful for the better user experience at all. Okay, we change it, and when the user first open that window, by default there will be no sorting. Okay, there. Okay guys, now it's working fine. Actually there is a problem came associated with call by reference, because actually I am doing the wrong thing. I assigning that take users in both list, available user and sorted available users. One thing more, the sorted available user is take the sorted data, but by default at first the data is not sorted, so it takes the same data as the available users. But I make a mistake that I assign take user in both list, available user and sorted available user. So when I make any changes in sorted available users, and as before take user assigned to the sorted available users, that changes also impact on the available users. That's why the available users data is totally changing. That's why there is some problem coming. So make sure you keep in mind about that call by reference or pass by reference thing, and for that I not assigning take users value here, because upon the real time changes, as this is the call by reference, as the address changes, there's also changes, just also impact on the available users at all. We can't make changes in the available user after that, because here all the data is present about the available connections at all. Cool. So what I made, I take the take users as like before and just mention it. That's the list type. This is not a very much big deal. And after that, we make a temporary list. That's a local list about take user after sorted. This temporarily take the sorted data. But as I said before, as when we start about open that screen, then the data is not sorted. So the sorted available users data list data and available user list data must be same. That's why we are just copying it. Okay. So what I do here, I make a enhanced loop here about the for each and add the data in that temporary list and add that list in the sorted available users. Hope you get it. If you have any confusion, comment it out. I will check it and I will try to reply it. So after that, let's see what I make changes in the onChange method. On the onChange method, the sorting takes some time. That's why we started the loading and we cleared the previous sorted result. Because if we not clear the previous sorted result and implementing the new changes, there might be some problem happen. So that's why we, when we start the loading, we cleared the previous data as well, previous sorted data, and then we start our real-time changes for that set state. And let's delete from that here because there is the repetition, so you can delete it from here and you can see it here. Okay, and this is the available users clear, and this is the debugging statement. The error happened, that's why I use that debugging statement to approach every point. And then what we can do, as I said before, without that function initial data fetch and checkup, that available user data will not change. So that available users will take the basic connection data that is available in the cloud Firestore as well, and then we iterate through the enhanced loop that available users and named every map as username map, and we are checking in that way if username map dot values dot first. Because if you see my previous video, the username map containing the key value as key as the user email and value as username and about separated with a special symbol. Okay, so that's the special separator as in value used for separate username and about. Hope you got it. And let's come back to the onChange method. And so we are checking, we are not bothering about the separator because the value, the map value, that username map value start with the username. So we are checking username map dot value dot first and convert it to string and convert it to the lower case so that there will be no conflict about the camel case and lower case character as well, because we are searching as case insensitive, not case sensitive mode. Okay, so convert to the lower case and just judging if it starts with that searching value. If I search here I make a hot reload for the changes. And okay, so here you can see when I press Sathi, irrespective of character case, it is showing the result. So if I back here, there is two name present, and yeah, and if I back here and I search for generation, that is showing here. Okay, so we are searching irrespective of the case, so our search is case insensitive. This will give us a better user experience. And we are searching if that starts with our searching user searching keyword. Okay, and if that is start with the searching keyword, just directly add it in the sorted available users list that we just clean before. To here we clean it to add the phrase connection username map. After that, all the things we just for the debugging purpose we print it and then we stop the loading. Okay, so here you can see if I search SA, there is two username start with SA, that's why 2 is showing. And now if I press T, then 1 showing, because that's the when we press T, only 1 is matching. And in that way, if I press Sam, then 1 is matching, that is showing here. But if I press G, so there is a single user start with G, that is generation. So if I back, you can see there is only one user start with G, that way this is showing in that way. So if I press in the capital, so this will only show the that same result, because we are searching irrespective of the username keyword case. Okay, so that's the searching, that's our target we completed in that video. From the next video, we are going to see about when user accept any connection request, then that connection will be visible here, and we will remove that demo connection view show in the next video. And after the accepting the connection, that connection will be shown here, and then we can starting with the UI of chat and also the backend functionality as well. Okay, so hope you guys enjoy this video. If you enjoy it, please like, comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon to get the regular video update of the tutorial and other video update of that channel. And guys, please let me know in the comments how you feel in that tutorial and also that in that video. So guys, that's all for today. Have a nice day. Bye bye.